हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम अभिलाषा शर्मा, फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट ऑफ बीटेक बायोटेक्नोलॉजी। द टॉपिक ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन टुडे इज प्रोडक्शन टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ रोज। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग, आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्रेस माय स्पेशल थैंक्स ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड टू अ कोर्स इंस्ट्रक्टर डॉक्टर प्रशांत बख्शी फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू फ्लरिश माई प्रेजेंटेशन स्किल्स एंड प्रेजेंट इट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू ऑल। कंटेंट्स: इंट्रोडक्शन, एरिया एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, यूजेस, क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन, सॉइल रिक्वायरमेंट एंड फील्ड प्रेपरेशन, प्लांटिंग डिस्टेंस, वेराइटीज, प्रोपोगेशन, आफ्टर केयर, प्रूनिंग, मैन्योरिंग, इरीगेशन एंड वीडिंग, रिजुविनेशन, हार्वेस्टिंग एंड हैंडलिंग, पेस्ट मैनेजमेंट, डिजीज मैनेजमेंट, पिंचिंग, पोस्ट हार्वेस्टिंग, मार्केटिंग, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन। इंट्रोडक्शन: A rose is a woody perennial flowering plant of the genus Rosa in the family Rosaceae. It is assumed that some of the important rose species were hybridized in nature and the present-day improved forms have been evolved over centuries. In fact, Crimson China Rose is considered as the father of modern roses. Out of every 120 species of roses distributed in the Old as well as the New World, only 8 species have played a major role in the development of the modern garden roses. The stem is prickly, the leaves are alternate and pinnately compound, the oval leaflets are sharply toothed, the fleshy berry-like fruit is known as hip. Roses have a determinant inflorescence that may assume corymbs, paniculate or solitary form. Area and distribution. Roses are being cultivated from ancient times in France, Cyprus, Greece, India, Iran, Italy, Morocco and USA for production of perfume. India. In India, roses produced in Karnataka, Maharashtra, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, New Delhi, Gujarat, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu and West Bengal. Uses: The rose is one of the oldest of fragrant flowers to be cultivated by man. Its different types having beautiful flowers of exquisite shape, sizes, bewitching colors and most delightful fragrance has made it an important flower for its varied uses. Rose hips are very good source of ascorbic acid. Every 100 gram of rose hip syrup contains 150 mg of ascorbic acid compared with only 50 mg present in fresh orange juice, 20 mg in tomatoes and 5 mg in apples. Most important uses of flower are given below. First, cut flowers. Roses are of foremost commercial importance and cut roses have the highest demand throughout the world and year round. The cut flowers are used for vase and table decoration. Second, garden display. Roses are also the most important perennial garden plants in almost all parts of the world. Roses are not only hardy, the variation in growth and many forms of flowers having numerous colors have made them the suitable garden plants for different uses. They can be used as bushes, standards, climbers, hedges and edges, hangers and in rock gardens. Third, pot plants. Roses as pot plants in suitable containers are also commercially grown and kept both indoor as well as outdoors. Perfume and Elise products. First one is rose water. It has the property of cooling the body and is often used in eye lotions and eye drops for its soothing qualities. Second is rose oil. Apart from sweet fragrance, it has medicinal property and is often used in Ayurveda. Bulgarian Rosa Oto is largely used in perfuming soaps and cosmetics. Third, rose petals are also preserved for direct consumption by making gulkan by pounding equal proportions of petals and white sugar. It is considered both as tonic and laxative. Climatic conditions. Temperature. Plants are planted at a place where flower yield can be highest at night temperature between 15 to 18 degrees Celsius and day temperature of 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. During winters, because of the low temperature, the quality of flowers is good. Light. A light duration lesser than 12 hours leads to lower number of flowers and inferior quality too. Humidity. In case of higher humidity in the atmosphere, water drops accumulate on the rose leaves, which if remain over there for a longer period leads to many fungal diseases. Certain diseases like mildews are associated with relative humidity. Season in which the crop is grown. It can be grown throughout the year. The best planting time is between September and October in plains, and in the hills it is during October to November or February to March. Planting can be avoided during hot summer and heavy rains. Soil requirement in field preparation. Preparation of soil is the key to success in roses, although any soil is good for rose cultivation provided it has proper drainage. The ideal soil should be medium loam having sufficient organic matter with a pH of 6.0 and 7.5. The soil should have a fine tilt up to a depth of 50 cm and should have a good drainage facility. The soil should be free from gravel, stones, brick pieces and other foreign material and exposed to sun for at least a week. If the soil is deficient of organic matter, then 10 to 12% of additional organic matter may be added to it. Upon land preparation, beds or plots of 1 to 1.5 meter wide and 30 to 40 meter long should be prepared. The beds or pits for planting are prepared at least a month before the date of planting. The preparation of beds may be taken up during May or June so that the soil gets a thorough exposure to sun and air, and during the rainy season it gets a chance to settle down before planting. Planting distance. The planting distance depends on the types of roses and location. Normally, roses are planted at 60 by 60 cm spacing. For cut flower production, a spacing of 60 by 30 cm is recommended. For oil extraction, a spacing of 2.5 by 0.5 meter is recommended. For vigorously growing cultivars, a spacing of 60 by 75 cm or 75 by 75 cm is recommended. For polyanthas, a spacing of 45 by 45 cm is recommended. For miniatures, a spacing of 30 by 30 cm is recommended. For climbing types, a spacing of 3 by 3 meter is recommended. Varieties. First is hybrid tea. This is the most important class of roses. The flower buds of this class are longer and look beautiful. The flowers of this class are slow opening and hence can be kept in vases for a longer time. Variety under different categories are in red, First Red, Avon, Happiness, Mr. Lincoln, Black Lady, etc. In yellow, Gold Medal, Golden Star, Golden Time, Yellow Success, Pusa Sonia. In orange, Superstar, Summer Holiday, President, and Grand Gala. In bicolor, Anvil Spark, Double Delight, Supriya, Kiss of Fire. In scented, Avon, Granda, Blue Perfume, Oklahoma. Second is Floribunda. There is profuse flowering in this class of roses, but the flowers shed soon. That's why this class of roses is largely used for decoration and wedding purpose. The important varieties under this class are as follows: in white, Iceberg, Summer Snow, Chandrama. In pink, Prema, Sadabahar, King Arthur, Bridal Pink. In yellow, Arthur Well, Dr. Phone, Sea Pearl, Golden Times. In mauve, Angel Face, Africa Star. In orange, Surya Kiran Jambra. In bicolor, Masked Red, Paint Box, Nav Sadabahar, Red Gold, Rare Edition. In scented, Angel Face, Delhi Princess. Third is Polyantha. The rose plants of this class are small and the flowers come in cluster. The main varieties of this class are Anjani, Rashmi, Narthaki, Preeti, Swati, etc. Fourth is Miniature. The roses of this class are dwarf in stature and the twigs and the leaves are also small. The flowers of this class are used in flower arrangement. The varieties are Red, Beauty Secret, Dark Beauty, Fast Fire, White, Green Eyes Annie, Pink, Windy City, Sweet Fairy, Dizzler, Yellow, Baby Gold Star, Cake Gold, Delhi Star Late, Mauve, Silver Tip, Bluebird, Bicolor, Star and Strip Over the Rainbow. Fifth, Climber. The branches of these roses are soft and spread like climber. They flower at the end of the branches in small clusters. They are used for raising over the pergolas and the walls. The important varieties are as follows: Enrant, Climbing Crimson Glory, Blaze Cocktail, Black Boy, in white, Delhi White Pearl, Rambler, American Pear, Lamarck, in pink, Climbing Showgirl, Lady Waterloo, Climbing of Silk, Soft Silk Climbing Pieces, in lemon, All Gold, Golden Shower, High Moon. Propagation. Commercial method of propagation is by cutting and budding. Cutting. Scented roses are mainly propagated through cuttings. Hardwood cuttings in case of polyanthus, climbers, ramblers, and soft or semi-hardwood cuttings for miniatures are used. Cuttings are collected from healthier plants with 15 to 20 cm length and 3 to 4 nodes. Cuttings are treated with IAABA 100 ppm. Cuttings are planted in mist chamber for easy and quicker rooting. Budding. Hybrid and Floribunda roses mainly propagated through budding. Debudding is the common method. Rootstock used are Rosa multiflora, Briar rootstock, Rosa indica variety odorata, Rosa lexa, Rosa canina. When a rose plant comes into flower, small phyllums are visible between the stem and stalk of the leaf. Select the eyes which are plump and not started to elongate and grow. Cut off the portions of the branch with the eye selected is called as budwood. With a budding knife, remove a shell-shaped piece of the bark and the eye. The root stock should be kept ready by cutting the branches and side shoots which are not required. Make a sharp horizontal cut at a suitable height in the stalk and then make a vertical T-shaped cut in the stem of the stalk. The eye should point towards the top and is tied with fiber. Pruning. Pruning is the removal of unwanted and unproductive portions of the plant and makes the plant more vigorous and productive. Time of pruning. Exactly 45 days prior to the date of requirement of flowers during October to December. Objective. To remove the unproductive shoots, to improve the quality of blooms, to bush in desired shape and size, to open up the bush to penetrate sunlight. How to prune? Remove dead, diseased or damaged wood. Remove branches that grow towards the center of the plant. Shape the plant. Make a cut at 45 degree angle, 1/4 inch above an outward facing bud. As you can see, in first picture, the cut is too high. In the second one, it is too low. And the third one is the correct way to make a cut when pruning is done. Aftercare. The newly planted roses require frequent watering at the beginning. After that, they may be watered once in 5 days during summer and once in 10 days during winter. If the soil is sandy, more frequent watering may be necessary. On the other hand, if the soil is heavy and retentive of moisture, the watering interval may have to be increased. Care should be taken to avoid wet feet, that is, to avoid stagnation of water too long in the beds or near the base of the plant as it is harmful to the roots. Suckers originating from the rootstock must be removed frequently to prevent the loss of vigor of the plants. Manuring. After pruning, bases are formed around the plant where sand manures are applied 10 to 15 cm in depth. 6:6:12 gram NPK per plant at wort and red rose, 8:8:16 gram NPK per plant in polyanthus. Application is done in 3 stages. First one is 15 DAP, second is after first flush of bloom, third is after second flush of bloom. Dose per plant: FIM 10 kg, urea 65 gram, superphosphate 25 gram, MOP 50 gram, foliar feeding micronutrient. 20 gram MnSO4 plus 15 gram MgSO4 plus 10 gram FeSO4 plus 5 gram boron. Add 2 gram per liter of water, results in bright colored flowers. Organic manures. Oil cakes and bone meal are excellent sources of nitrogen and phosphorus respectively and may be applied after pruning. Irrigation and weeding. Irrigation. Flood irrigation is given at 10 days interval depending upon the soil and climate. Avoid irrigation immediately before and after pruning. Weeding. Mulching 2 to 4 inches of organic material like wood chips if found to reduce annual weeds and make hand weeding easier. Manual weeding is effective. Hoeing and roguing is also effective. Effective control of broad leaf weeds by spraying with 2 40 at the rate of 2 kg per 600 liter of water per hectare 25 to 30 days before flowering, followed by cultivation of soil to the depth of 6 to 10 cm. Rejuvenation, harvesting and handling. Rejuvenation. After 5 to 6 years, the plants are to be rejuvenated. Cut back all the main branches at 15 to 20 cm from the base. Apply body of paste over cut ends to prevent diseases. Harvesting. Flowering starts from 1st year onwards, economic yield 2nd to 10th year. Flowers are harvested when the flower buds are in half open stage. For cut flowers, they are harvested at tight bud stage with long stalks. Handling. As soon as the flowers are harvested, the stems are harvested. The stems are lowered in to clean buckets containing water with preservative. The flowers are then cooled down to 2 to 4 degrees Celsius for 5 to 6 hours. The flowers are graded according to the length of the flower stalk. It varies from 40 to 110 cm depending on the variety and packed 20 per bunch. Pest management. Aphids, Macrocyphum rosae. The incidence is more in the months of January to February on leaves and flower buds. The young and adults both suck the sap from the young twigs, buds and flowers. They suck the salt sap, discolor the leaves and affect flower buds which fall and lose their beauty. This can be effectively controlled by spraying 0.1% Malathion or Metasystox 0.1 to 0.2% or Rogol 0.1 to 0.2%. Shepherd beetles. Onycetonia versicolor. The adults of these beetles appear in August to September and cut away the leaves. This can be controlled by monocrotophos 1 ml per liter or dimethoate 1.5 ml per liter. Red scale nelicapsis rosae. It is very serious pest of roses which attack mostly in August and September. The branches are covered with reddish-brown incrustations under which the insect sucks the juice of the plants. These pests can be controlled by spraying Malathion 0.1% or Parathion 0.25% in April and again in October. Disease management. Dieback Diplodia rosarum. This is a very serious disease of roses and appears after pruning. The drying up and blackening of pruned shoots start from top to downwards. At the point where dry and healthy twigs meet, there appears brown lining and also black spots appear at these places. The conditions favorable for the prevalence of the disease are application of large fertilizers and manure, excessive irrigation and poor drainage facility, continuous incidence of mites, less light penetration. For its effective control, the infected portion should be dehisced and burnt and the cut end should be painted with chabotia paste, that is 4 part copper carbonate plus 4 part red lead plus 5 parts linseed oil, or body of paste, application of optimum dose of fertilizer and by facilitating proper drainage or spray of 3 gram per liter of copper oxychloride 50%. Black spot diplocarpon rosae. This disease appears in during the humid months. Conspicuous circular black spot less than 1 cm with fringed margins appear on either side of leaf. Leaves become chlorotic, dry up and prematurely drop. It can be easily controlled by spraying carbendazim 1 gram per liter of water fungicide at fortnightly intervals. Powdery mildew. Sparrowtheca pannosa. It is a serious disease that occurs when days are warm and nights are cool. Young growing shoots and leaves are covered with white powdery growth. Infected leaves turn purplish and drop. Flower buds may fail to open. It can be checked by removing all the infected leaves at the time of pruning so that the source of infection is damaged, or dusting with 80% sulfur or spraying 0.1% carathene fungicide at fortnightly intervals. Pinching. Apical portion of shoot, if removed early, a large number of axillary shoots arise, resulting in well-shaped bushy plants bearing more number of uniform flowers. The removal of shoot apices 40 days after transplanting enhances the flower yield. Pinching in rows is generally practiced to adjust flowering for a particular season. Pinching has to be done above a 5 leaflet leaf with a rounded bud. The shoots selected for later flower production are pinched by removing 3 to 5 cm of terminal growth after at least 15 cm growth is formed. These shoots may again be pinched after 4 to 6 weeks. This procedure of pinching prevents flowering and encourages the plants to form new growth, the base. Post-harvesting. After harvesting, the flowers, they are dried on floor under shade for 2 to 3 days. Upon drying, the seeds are separated by hammering the flowers and the flower straw is separated out by winnowing of the hammered flowers. The seeds are thoroughly cleaned and graded before packing in poly bags or cloth bags. The moisture contents of the seeds must be examined before the packing. Marketing, distribution and transportation. Crop has a good demand in decoration, garlands, loose flower and religious function, etc. So can be marketed to major oblique big cities where these can be supplied to hotels, institutions, etc. For garlands distribution, flowers should be packed in bamboo basket which should be covered under moist muslin cloth. Thank you.